Problem number two, add or subtract the radical expression. So we have 1/3 the square root of a plus 3/4 the square root of a plus 3/5 and the square root of a. So the radical is the same in each term, a, and the index is also the same in each term, which is 2. Therefore, we can go ahead and just add all the coefficients, which are the numbers in front of the radical, together. Let me do a little bit side work over here, because these are fractions and they do not have the same common denominator. So our first step would be finding the least common denominator of all these fractions. And if I look at 3, 4, and 5, they do not have common factors. I'm going to end up just multiplying these three denominators together. So 3 times 4 times 5 gives me 60. So 60 would be my least common denominator for all three fractions. Now to get to 60, I would have to multiply 3 times 20. And I would have to do that to the denominator and the numerator to keep the fraction as is with the same value. Then 4, I would have to multiply 4 by 15 to get 60, and I'm going to do that with the denominator and the numerator. And with 5, I would have to multiply 5 times 12 to get 60, and again I do that with numerator and denominator. So just rewriting my fractions right here, 1 times 20 is 20, and then plus 3 times 15, which gives me 45, and then 3 times 12, which gives me 36. Now I'm ready to add the numerators together, and 20 plus 45 plus 63 gives me 101, and all that over 60. Now I can check if I can reduce the fraction, but I'm pretty sure that 101 and 60 do not have a common factor, so this would be my final fraction for this problem. And then the square root stays the same, so I have a square root of a, which definitely I cannot simplify. So 101 over 60 with the square root of a is my final answer for this question.